Hello and welcome to a new video here on my channel here at commaik. In this video, I would like to show you how I transfer the hard drives from my old QNAP TS-421 NAS to take over all data into the new QNAP TS-664 NAS. If you are interested, stay tuned. It's about to start. My old NAS, the QNAP TS-421, has served me for many years as reliable data storage. It serves as my media server and it is used for processing many background processes in my house. The hard drives have a capacity of 4 TB. Of this, I have installed 4 pieces in a RAID 5 configuration in the device. However, the storage space is nearly exhausted. I could simply replace the hard drives with larger models. However, I must say that the device is somewhat outdated. The 1 GB of RAM? This device is not expandable, and the CPU performance is relatively weak for today's standards. Time. For this reason, I decided to acquire a new NAS. This QNAP TS-664 has a significantly higher performance and can additionally accommodate up to 6+2 hard drives. Today, I will transfer the hard drives with the data from the old NAS directly into the takeover the QNAP NAS. If that works, I will equip the server with additional hard drives. How to expand this 18 TB hard drive. I will also upgrade the memory of the QNAP TS-664 expand. According to the manufacturer, the RAM is limited to a maximum of 16 GB. Of this, 4 GB is already included by default. Installed. However, I have increased the RAM to 32 GB. I am curious if I can achieve that. How to achieve that? But before I start, I would like to first show you what preparations are necessary to transfer the hard drives 1.1 to the new QNAP NAS. Since the QNAP NAS systems are not all compatible with each other, QNAP offers its own website where you can test if a migration is possible. I will provide the link you under video in the description. The website, I first capture the operating system that both NAS systems must have. In my case, it is the QTS. QTS. If you are not sure, you can check that through the web interface of the old NAS query. The source NAS is equipped with 4 drives, and the model number is 421. The target NAS has 6 drives. And the model number is TS-664. You can see that the system has already given me a green check mark, issued. I can migrate the hard drives from my old QNAP TS-421 to the QNAP TS-664. In step 2, some settings must be checked on the source NAS and adjusted if necessary. To do this, you log into the web interface of the NAS and switch to the tile, Control Panel. In the Control Panel, the firmware should first be checked. If the firmware is not up to date, it must be brought up to the current version. If you should use a cache, for example via SSD hard drives, must be disabled in the corresponding settings. In my case, it is. This function is not available because my old QNAP NAS does not support caching. In the application manager, you should deactivate the licenses of the purchased or subscribed apps. The apps are linked to the device and cannot be directly transferred to the new NAS. You must first be logged out and then logged back in on the new device. That is not available to me as I do not run such apps on this server. The fourth point is the important backup of the user account settings, server names and network configuration. Essentially, the new NAS takes over the settings of the old QNAP, but to be on the safe side, I click on backups and have shortly created a .bin file. That was already all the preparations that were necessary. Now the hard drives from the old NAS can be directly installed into the new NAS. The old hard drives can now be removed from the source NAS. It is important that the order in which the hard drives were installed in the old NAS to keep in any case. For this reason, I will make a mark on the attach the hard drive so that I do not confuse it. After inserting and screwing the hard drives into the new cages, I was able to simply slide them into the new NAS in the correct order. Before I start the NAS, I first installed the QFinder Pro. The program is available on the website of. To easily and simply find QNAP, go to the support section, Desktop Utilities, where you will conveniently find the useful QFinder Pro tool located, various operating systems available. I have already installed the program. And you can see that the QFinder is automatically scanning for a QNAP NAS on the network. So far, the program hasn't found anything yet. I will now start the QNAP TS-664. Upon completion of the boot process, the QFinder has found the QNAP on the network and this in displayed on the user interface. In the status, it is shown to me that the migration of the hard drives has been successfully completed. I am also advised to update the firmware. I can do that directly. I will do this using this button. In the login, I enter my user data from the old system. NAS. The QFinder Pro offers me to automatically update the firmware to update to the latest version. I will transfer this option to my new NAS QNAP TS-664. The firmware update was successfully completed. The message that the SMTP server has not yet been configured appears automatically. This message asks whether the server should now be set up. It is important to respond to the request without fail. To confirm with no, the server must not be configured at this point. Once the boot process is completed after the firmware update, I can connect using the IP address. Log into the QNAP from the QFinder on the web interface. The password is the same as in the old NAS. The system provides some notes I will address afterwards. In the control center, my hard drives are displayed along with their data consumption in relation to each other. The total capacity has not changed. My data has been transferred 1.1. In the file station, my folders and the files contained within them are also visible. My linked drives in the Windows folder are still present. I can access all files without having to make any settings. Although all functions are generally available, I will take my time to familiarize myself with the new system to deal with. Because the new QNAP TS-664 NAS offers significantly more features than my old system. First, however, I will make some settings on the system. Among other things, I will adjust the name and also check the permissions of the users. In the storage overview, my four hard drives can be seen. The available capacities, the free. Slots for the fifth and sixth positions are visible here. These are the SSD slots for the cache. The migration from the old QNAP TS-421 to the QNAP TS-664 took about 20 to 30 minutes. The new system runs quickly and stably, even when some analysis programs are still running in the background. Run. Once these are completed, I will continue and increase the storage capacity of the new. Expand the QNAP TS-664 by installing larger hard drives as well as the SSD drives. The RAM memory will be expanded soon enough, as soon as the system runs stably enough. If you want to see how I do the increase hard drives and adjust the RAID and how I upgrade the RAM according to the official guidelines. If I can get it running beyond 16 GB, then subscribe to my channel now. Click on the subscribe button at the bottom right button. Don't forget to give me a thumbs up if you liked my video. I'm already looking forward to the next video and hope you will be there. Until then, take care. Bye.